Hi there, welcome to Operator Tuition Services. In this video, we'll be looking at the determinants of a matrix. Please like, subscribe, and share. So we'll begin by looking at what the determinant of a matrix is. So the determinant of a matrix is a scalar value that can be computed from the elements of a square matrix. This means that we can only find the determinants of square matrices. And the determinant of a matrix A is denoted that A are 2 bars with A in it. They all mean we are talking about the determinant of matrix A, talking about the determinant of matrix A. So how do we find the determinant of a 2x2 matrix? The determinant of a 2x2 matrix. So assuming the matrix A is given by the elements A, B, C, and then D, then with these bars with the elements in, this is what we mean by the determinant of A, the determinant of A. And this is how we find the determinant of A. You find the product of the two elements on the principal diagonal minus the product of the two elements on the auxiliary diagonal. So we have A times D minus B times C. So the scalar value that you get from this expression here will be the determinant of the 2x2 matrix. Let's look at an example. So we are to find the determinant of the matrix J, where the elements are 7, 8, 6, and then 7. So this will be the determinant of matrix J, 7 times 7. So we have 7x7 minus 6x8. So 6x8, 7x7 is giving us 49. Minus 6x8, which is 42. So the determinant for matrix J is 1. The determinant for matrix J is 1. Let's look at example 2. We have to find the determinant of the matrix H, 1, 1, 2, 2. So just like before, we find the products of the elements on the principal diagonal, which is 1 and 2. So 1x2 minus 2x1, and that is giving us 0. That is giving us 0. So this is how we find the determinant of a 2x2 matrix. The determinant of a 2x2. So let's take these practice questions that we can practice on our own. You can put your answers in the comment section. Whatever question today you have, you can put them in the comment section and I'll get back to you. So find the determinant of the following matrices. This is determinant matrix A. You find the determinant of matrix A. Then for question 2, you find the determinant of matrix B. Then the third question 2, you find the determinant of matrix C. So let's move on to how to find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix. Determinant of a 3x3 matrix. So assuming we have a matrix A with the elements A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and then I. How do we find the determinant of this 3x3 matrix A? So if there's the matrix A, then this is what gives us the determinant of the matrix A, the matrix A. We can use any row. See, we can use the first row to find the determinant. We can use the second row or the third row. We can even use the columns, but we should just be careful of the rows or the columns that we use because we need to use their various signs, their various signs. So using the first row, the first element in the matrix has a positive sign. The second element has a negative sign. We'll talk about this when we are talking about cofactors of a matrix. And then C2 has a positive sign. So if you want to find the determinant of matrix A, when you take A, you find the product of the minor of A and then A. Okay, how do we get the minor of the element A? We get the minor of the element A by collapsing the row and the column that A lies on. So you collapse the row for A, which is ABC, and then the column for A, which is ADG. Then you find the determinant of the resultant 2x2 matrix. So when we collapse this row, the first row and the first column, then we'll be left with this 2x2 matrix. So we have E, F, H, and I as the elements of the resultant 2x2 matrix. So we'll find A times the determinant of that 2x2 matrix. Then because B has a negative sign, go to minus B by, when you pick element B, you cancel the row and then you cancel the column. So we'll be left with the 2x2 matrix D, F, G, H. That's what we have here. So you find the product of B and then S minor, which is the determinant of the 2x2 matrix. Then we go to C. C has a positive sign. So we have positive C. Then we find the minor of C, which is by canceling the row and then canceling the column. So we'll be left with the resultant 2x2 matrix D, E, G, A. That's what we have here. So that's the minor for C. We find the determinant for this 2x2. So after performing this operation, the scalar value that you get to be the determinant for matrix A, the determinant for matrix. So this is how we find the determinant of a 3x3 matrix. Okay, so let's look at the first example, example one. You have to find the determinant of the matrix this. So we find the determinant of this matrix, the determinant of this matrix. So just like the procedure that we just looked at, first, we are going to use the first rule to find the determinant of this. So after picking the first element, which is minus 2, we collapse the row and then the column. Then we find the determinant of the resultant matrix. So this is the resultant matrix. We find the determinant of this 2x2 matrix. And if you remember, I said the second element has a negative sign. So we have minus, minus 1. Then we collapse this row and then this column. This is the resultant 2x2 matrix that will be left. We will find the determinant of that. Then we go to the last element on the first row. So we cancel this column, we cancel this row. This is the resultant 2x2 matrix that we'll be left with. So we just performed this operation. We just learned how to find the determinant of a 2x2 matrix. The product of the elements on the principal diagonal minus the product of the elements on the other diagonal. So that's what we have here, minus 2x2, that's what we have here. And then this by this. Then we come to the second one, negative times negative will give us a positive number. So we have positive 1. Then the product of the elements on the principal diagonal 1x2 minus then the product of the elements on the auxiliary diagonal. We do same for the second thing, we do same for the second thing. So we just perform this operation and then we are getting a determinant of 13, determinant of 13. So this is our first example. Let's look at example 2. So we have to find the determinant of the matrix. This is the matrix that we have to find is determinant. We are still using the first row to find the determinant. So when we pick the first element 2, remember it has a positive sign. We cancel the column, we cancel the row. So we have 1, minus 5, 2, 4 as the resultant matrix. So we find the determinant of this 2x2 matrix, which is the minor for 2. Then we go to the second thing, which is 0. Remember, it has a negative sign. So minus 0 times is minor. So if you want to find the minor of 2, you cancel the row and the column, then the resultant 2x2 matrix, you find the determinant of that, and you get your minor for 0. Then we move on to 5, which is the last element on the first row. That one has a positive sign, so we have a positive here. So how do we get the minor for 5? We cancel the first row and then we cancel the last column. So we'll be left with this 2x2 matrix. So we just find the determinant of this 2x2 matrix. So for this part, we have 2 by finding the determinant of this 1 times 4 minus 2 times minus 5. So that's what we have here, the determinant for this 2x2 matrix minus. Then the product of the elements on the principal diagonal. So we have this by this, minus 0 by minus 5. We do same for this one too. So when we are done, 1x4 minus 2 minus 5 will be positive 10. So we have 4 plus 10, which is 14. So we do same, we do the algebra for all the two terms, and then we add everything together. We are getting minus 2. So this means that the determinant of this matrix is minus 2. It's minus 2. All right, I hope we can now do find the determinant of a matrix. Let's take this practice question. So Let's write them, put our answers in the comment section. If you have a question too, you can put it there. I'll get back to you. This is, we have to find the determinant of matrix A and then matrix B. Okay. And one thing we have to note is that if the determinant of a matrix is zero, then it means that that matrix does not have an inverse. We cannot have find the inverse of that matrix. And when it happens like that, the matrix is said to be invertible. The matrix is said to be invertible. So a matrix without a determinant will have no inverse. And as a result, we call it invertible. Call it invertible. So this is the end of our video on determinants of a matrix. All right, in our next video, we'll be looking at the inverse of a matrix. Please let's subscribe, like, and then share. Thank you.